Good morning and welcome to St. Anthony's. Today is Thursday, June 17th, and our Mass is being offered for the repose of the soul of Nick Busse.
Our opening hymn is number 534, Sing to the Mountains, 534, verses 1 and 2.
Lord Jesus, you have sent the heal the contrite. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you call us to follow you. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, by your death and resurrection, you brought us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, strength of those who hope in you, graciously hear our pleas and since without you, our mortal frailty can do nothing. Grant us always the help of your grace, that in following your commands, we may always please you by our resolve and our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, if only you would put up with a little foolishness from me, please put up with me. For I am jealous of you with the jealousy of God, since I betrothed you to one husband to present you as a chaste virgin to Christ. But I am afraid that, as the serpent deceived Eve by his cunning, your thoughts may be corrupted from a sincere and pure commitment to Christ. For if someone comes and preaches another Jesus than the one we preached, or if you receive a different spirit from the one you received, or a different gospel from the one you accepted, you put up with it well enough. For I think that I am not in any way inferior to these super apostles. Even if I am untrained in speaking, I am not so in knowledge. In every way, we have made this plan to you in all things. Did I make a mistake when I humbled myself so that you might be exalted, because I preached the gospel of God to you without charge? I plundered on other churches by accepting from them in order to minister to you. And when I was with you and in need, I did not burden anyone, for the brothers who came from Macedonia supplied my needs. So I refrained and will refrain from burdening you in any way. By the truth of Christ in me, this boast of mine shall not be silenced in the regions of Achaia. And why? Because I do not love you? God knows I do. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm. Your works, O Lord, are justice and truth.
Your works, O Lord, are justice and truth.
I will give thanks to the Lord with all my heart in the company and assembly of the just. Great are the works of the Lord, exquisite in all their delights.
Your works, O Lord, are justice and truth.
Majesty and glory are his work, and his justice endures forever. He has won renown for his wondrous deeds. Gracious and merciful is the Lord.
Your works, O Lord, are justice and truth.
The works of his hands are faithful and just. Sure are all his precepts, reliable forever and ever, wrought in truth and equity.
Your works, O Lord, are justice and truth. Alleluia. In today's gospel, Jesus taught us how to pray. How did we are called to address God?
Our Father.
Our Father. What is the significance of that? Why not my Father? Why our Father?
Because he is our Father. He created everything and created us.
Yes, but why our Father? Yes, he created all that, but wouldn't I say my Father did all that?
He's everybody's father, our father.
Yes, he's every father's father. What does that mean? That the Episcopalian, the Southern Baptist, the Baptist Church,
yeah,
those other people of faith, of faith, or even people, the Mormons, let's include a little more, expand our horizon.
Yeah.
Seventh-day Adventists, how about
He loves them as much as he loves us.
That's right. How about the atheists?
Yep.
Is he also their father?
Yep.
And how about those, well, I guess those who believe in him. That includes pretty much everybody.
Yeah.
All the believers and non-believers. So what does that mean? That even if you don't recognize him, that he's still your father. And what does, how does that affect us? Because we're called, because everyone is called, whether they recognize him or not, that they're still, that God is still their father.
Well, that means we have to accept them where they're at, because God does.
That's right. Like you're all, I guess it's safe to say in every family, there's a black sheep. There are those who said, I don't belong to this family. I don't want to belong in this family. In fact, I'm going to change my last name to make sure that everybody knows I don't belong to this family. And when a person does that, does that change the fact that they belong to the family?
No.
How come? Their name to last name changed.
Well, that you just can't erase someone who is your father. You can't.
It's a factual statement, right?
Yeah, it's always with you. It's always a fact of life.
Right, whether you accept it or not, yeah. The reality is there. You can't undo that. You can't change it. And if you notice today, to be one with, to really take this word seriously, the Our Fathers, that God to really proclaim this word as a factual statement and a reality of life, does it happen by accident to make this a reality in our life? I mean, it's already a reality, I know that. But to live it out, does it happen by accident?
Oh, no.
It's something that one works to making it a deeper reality. Isn't it?
Yeah.
Now you know, your family, look at your own family. For you, for your siblings and you to proclaim that your parents, our parents, it's a reality, it's a factual statement, but also to make it more of a reality in your life means that you have to practice living as brother and sisters in that family. And does that always go smoothly?
No.
No, there's always squabbles, grumbling, resentment, upsets. I guarantee it, if it doesn't happen, wait for it. It will happen. Wait for any weddings, any funerals, or any occasion when the family gets together. There's bound to be something going on there. And in the midst of that, how are we called to live with one another? How does one live as brother and sisters? If you notice the Our Father prayer, and there's instruction how to do that.
Yeah.
By doing what?
Forgiving them.
By forgiving one another.
Yeah.
And the Lord even makes a strong statement. Unless you forgive your brothers and sisters, what's going to happen to you?
We can't be forgiven.
That's right. You are not going to be forgiven. And that should be something very shocking in our life. Like, oh, even if I don't want to forgive my brother, guess what? I have to, because if I want, unless I'm the sinless one, unless I'm so sure that I don't sin at all, that I don't owe any God anything, then I guess I don't have to worry. I'm good, right?
Yeah, no.
No? Because what does St. Paul say? You say you don't have sin. If you think you don't have sin, you're a liar, right?
Deceive yourself.
Yes, you deceive yourself. You're a liar. All sin falls short of God's grace. So if you say you don't need God's forgiveness, well, guess what happens? You're lying to yourself. St. Paul talks about it clearly. There's no buts and ifs or anything. He says we're all sinners. That you're deceiving yourself. And if you do that, your prayer, or just like, you'll be just like the pagans, the unbelievers, because they pray and they just babble. And what does it mean to babble?
Just talk for the sake of hearing your own voice.
Yes, making a bunch of senseless noise. It doesn't really, you're not saying too much. It doesn't really have any meaning. You're just blah, 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 blah. You're just making a bunch of senseless noise. And I wonder sometimes, do we, when we pray, do we really do that? If we do, how does that happen?
If we just babble? Is that what
you Yes, mean? How does babbling happen? Can we ever babble the Our Father prayer? How does that happen, Jeanette?
You're not paying attention. Your mind's someplace else.
That's right. You're just saying a bunch of words that doesn't mean a lot to you. You're on automatic pilot. You're just reciting something perhaps you believe or not believe in your own life, that you don't even live in your life. You just babble. You just say a bunch of things that you really don't understand, don't comprehend, or don't even don't care about your life, that you don't practice. And it's a scary thing. You know, if you really take this prayer seriously, is it an easy prayer to live out?
Not always.
Not always. In fact, you're honest, you know, it takes a lifetime of work. Think about it. In your own life, did you ever have to question and struggle when terrible things happen to you? Do I trust in God when God takes away my eyesight? When the Lord takes away my mobility and the things I value of my life? Takes away my children? Take away things I hold treasure in my life? You know, I mean, do I trust that God will provide for me? Will get me through this? And if I lose my husband someday, do I trust that he'll help to make it through it? My husband of 64 years, who I love dearly more than anything else in the world. I mean, you know, when you think about it.
Well, you have to start building the trust.
That's right.
Something happens.
Yeah, it's a constant in your life, as in our life, it's a constant step-by-step trust. That we don't know how much we trust until we're tested throughout our life. And we don't know how much we can handle, betrayal can we take before we break. And that's where God's grace comes in. That's why if we trust in God's grace, we believe that I know that I can't do this on my own. But do you know who can do it? God can, because God's grace is sufficient enough for me. And so today, my brothers and sisters, I just invite you to reflect on this prayer, but not to lose heart, not to be afraid, because God's grace is more than sufficient for you and me in our life. If we do what? To trust in Him. If we believe in Him, we're not going to spend endless nights staying awake worrying about, are we be able to do this? Because with God's grace, with God, everything is possible.
Amen.
Trusting in God's love and mercy, let us turn to Him now for all our needs and all the needs of the world. For Pope Francis, for Alexander, our bishop, and all our priests, bishops, and deacons, may God's grace be upon them to help them to lead and guide their people to everlasting life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For each and every one of us, may we truly be able to live out this prayer in our life and recognize God's greatness in our life and be able to forgive and love one another. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us also pray for all the prayers that concern the words that lie deep in our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us also pray for all our brothers and sisters who have gone before us, trusting and believing God's love and mercy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving, compassionate Father, accept the prayers of your family gathered here. Help each and every one of us, Lord, to turn to you, that in doing so, may we experience your love and your mercy. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our song for the presentation of the gifts is number 352, Seed Scattered and Sown, 352.
Through the land.
only that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
O God, who in the offering presented here, provide for the twofold needs of human nature, nourishing us with food and renewing us with your sacrament. Grant, we pray, that the sustenance they provide may not fail us in body or in spirit, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks, O Lord, our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself, was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death. And by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as if our end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is a chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord,
and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis our Pope and Alexander our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit be co-heir to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other some peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
There is one thing I ask of the Lord. Only this do I seek, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life.
Act of Spiritual Communion.
Jesus, thank you for coming into our hearts. We welcome you and unite ourselves to you. Strengthen us in your love as we await the day we are reunited at the Eucharistic table. Amen.
Our communion hymn is number 680, The Lord is My Light, 680.
Yeah.
of your faithful, so it may bring about unity in your church through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Unity in our church doesn't happen by accident. It takes work, it's an intentional effort. And the way, great way to unite one another is by sharing one story with each other, by giving testimony. So I invite you to be a guest columnist in our church bulletin. Allow, share your stories with others. Help inspire one another in living our faith, especially at times of our lives. I have heard many wonderful reviews from folks whose lives have been touched by your, by the people's testimony so far. How they really look forward to it. I know, because I've seen it happen. So I just invite you to thank those who have generously contributed your story, but all those who are maybe needs a little bit push, inspired to do that. So I just invite you to do that, to share your story with one another. Now, if you have a difficult time doing that, writing is not your thing, Lisa Hoffman, one of our noted writers, agreed to help you with that. So we're really blessed to have her help. So if you'd like to do that, let us know. Also, remember, July's issue and the latest Catholic Sentinels are available in front of the church in Mai's Asian Market for you to pick up. Also, God in His goodness always willing to forgive our sins. So if you would like to go to confession, email me. My email is on our webpage. Also, for all couples celebrating the anniversary. Also, if you have a difficult time, Lisa Hoffman agreed to help you with that if you need to help writing. Also, remember, be sure to email us a picture of your wedding photo, recent photo, date, and place of your wedding, and a poignant funny memory. Let us celebrate together. Also, remember, the daily Mass change is going to happen next week. It starts from Tuesday to Friday. Mass is at what time?
9 a.m.
in the morning. Rise up early and come and join us before the chicken crows. So, before the rooster crows, come and join us for a wonderful Mass at 9 a.m. in the morning. And for those who are sadly not able to join us, what option do you have?
Watch it on the internet.
That's right. It's available online and also live for you to also to watch through Facebook. Yes, through the marvels of modern technology, we're also available for you a little bit later down the day.
And Father, are these pre-taped or is it Tuesday is Tuesdays and...
Tuesday is Tuesday and Wednesday is Wednesday, et cetera, et cetera. Okay. On the same day. It makes it a lot simpler for you guys. Also, we're back to regular Bible study. That means on Wednesday at 9:30 a.m. in the parish hall, we'll meet with one another. There. So join us, not only for the Word of God, but also to be fed, literally, with wonderful fresh baked pastry and fresh made coffee. Do join us. I know one of our parishioners feels already signed up for it. He's really excited for both. I don't know what his motive is, but it's questionable. But either way, he's getting the Word of God there. Also join us to help me to congratulate and also pray for Camille, Oscar, and Michael. He'll be confirmed. They will be confirmed this Sunday coming up, June the 20th at the 9 a.m. Mass. And remember, July is quickly approaching. Is rapidly approaching. We have the Strawberry Festival, so come and join us. That's on July the 3rd. The 3rd, yes, the 3rd. Wait. Yes, July the 3rd. So join us for that weekend for Strawberry Festival. And also the picnic will be on June the 11th. So join for me for that, for my celebration for anniversary coming up.
So you
mean July.
July.
Yes, July. Yeah, so many things. In case you forgot any of that stuff and you want to refresh your memory, it's all in the bulletin. So don't you worry if you stay, you feel you missed something. You can rewind or you can, yes, in this day and age of online, you can rewind and watch parts of it over again. Also, so yes, you can read all this in the bulletin, on our wonderful bulletin. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking to ruin the souls. Amen.
Our closing hymn is number 442, How Can I Keep From Singing? Verses 1, 2, and 3. 442.